Southwest from Mexico. Made sure the tariffs fell and made the English settle the Oregon Territory. He built an independence treasury. By the count of all this, he sucks no sack at all.
It's been
96 years, according to this person.
96
it
years.
It feels like 50 years.
Yes.
It's been longer than that.
With the wind chill, it feels like.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we've got quite a show for you. We've got a brand new album out called Nanobots. We've got all these old albums out that are currently filling landfill all across America. Doing our part to keep the economy of recycling going. And so this is a song off some album we did.
Check the landfill.
Yeah.
Figure it out.
I'm trying to figure out what album this is from. This is from The Spawn, right?
Spawn.
It's from an album called The Spawn. I think.
Maybe not.
You know? It's like when you have, you know, 16 kids, you know, it's like,
you
hey.
You forget all their names.
Yeah, it's like, hey, kiddo.
Hey, champ, how you doing?
Hey, champ, get me another beer. Like that. So this song is called, Hey, Champ, Get Me Another Beer.
Somebody.
six chord.
I think we need to do a six chord.
The six chord makes you bow.
Yeah. Is it the ghost of the Beatles enters your body?
Miller, what are you giving out over there? Okay. Just curious.
Very, very considerate. Let it be known, they might be giants. A considerate band. Hey! Is it hot in here, or is it just this tremendously sexy audience and band? That's right. It's hot in here.
I don't know what you mean.
It's tremendously hot in here. So we've got a whole bundle of songs, some of which we know how to play.
Keep up your hands together. Rolling Car. The Enforcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we know some people were feeling a little bit shy during the hand clapping part of that last song. We have to remind all those people who are feeling shy that we have actually sealed the doors of the club right now. So the next portion of the show is entirely driven by audience participation, ladies and gentlemen. But fortunately, unlike a lot of audience participation, which is kind of like, everybody get along, this one feeds on the negative energy that can be conjured up within an audience. So this is how it works, everybody. I hold in my hands a South American medical instrument, and I'm going to use this to divide the audience directly in half. If you are in the line of this beam of light, I advise you to get out of the way of this. Cat's Cradle's rules insist that you get out of the way of the light. I need a 6-foot means of egress. Excuse me, sir, if you could just shimmy over a little bit. People over here, can you give the people some room so they can squeeze over to the left or the right? Same over here. I'm not saying we are going to go tumbling, John Belushi, Blues Brothers style through the audience. But it has happened. Of course, it was not a member of the band, it was just some guy. But we need a 6-foot means of egress. In fact, people behind the soundboard, people in the way back, people in the cool seats, the rock critics who got in for free, can you please step to the left or the right, because we actually need to divide the audience directly in half. Please decide. This is the United States. You have freedom of choice. You can choose one or the other. All right, this is perfect. I see a lady's getting sassy. And this one man is taking his cue to get back to his dark room. Okay, so this is how it works, everybody. Everybody over here on the right, your musical representatives on stage are Mr. Dan Miller, Marty Beller, and Mr. Daniel Weinkauf, who's somewhere around behind me. Please hoist your right fists in the air and chant with them. People, 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 people. Okay, that's good. That's good. You are going to be representing the people, ladies and gentlemen. So organize yourselves, start your street teams, find your illicit funding, and get ready. We do like to remind everyone that, like reality TV, this is only a competition. You didn't come here to make friends. It's only about winning. There is only one winner, and it will be determined over the course of this enterprise, which can take up to 18 minutes. So save your energy. But you know, I think you guys could have done that soundtrack a little bit louder. A little more volume, a little less feeling. Here we go, everybody, you guys psyched? You guys ready? You're mumbling amongst yourselves. Right fist in the air, everybody. Chant.
People, 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 people.
Okay. Truly scary. All right, everybody over here. Oh, look, we've got a little extra bonus area. Oh, wow, and it goes way back. This might actually be an unfair advantage. You people need to hoist your left fists in the air, and your musical representatives on stage, Mr. John Linnell and myself, we will join you. This is, you are representing the apes. Please chant the word apes. That is very strong. Please shut up. That is very strong and almost intimidating from where we're standing. So ladies and gentlemen, this is how it works. While the apes are chanting, the people must be silent. While the people are chanting, the apes must be silent. It goes back and forth. There will be only one announced winner. I hope I'm being clear enough. And by the way, I've given all of you a mild case of cataracts at a very early age. So here we go. It starts with the people. Right fists in the air. Then prepare yourself. Here we go.
Pump, 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 pump,
Chicken fights in the parking lot right after the show. Spontaneous chicken fights. You can send some Twitter photos of that. Very, very exciting. So John, tell us about the next song.
Chickens and Apes Together. It's freaky. Here's speaking of the animal kingdom, this is a song about the mammalian It's poetic, so don't use it on your zoology test. I know it's a little late to start warning people about it.
When you say poetic, do you mean it's not true?
It's true in a sense, like, you know, the truth that's beyond truth. Whoa, you know what I'm talking about. Whoa, it's music. Here we go, mammal.
Mammal, mammal,
got Dan Miller back on the guitar, ladies and gentlemen. We've got Danny Weinkopf randomly playing bass. He's going to join us center stage where he belongs, playing the keyboards. And then, of course, you've seen clarinets with other bands. But our clarinet has a poking stick, ladies and gentlemen. They Might Be Giants has been part of a VH1 Save the Music project where we go around right after shows in the middle of the night and steal band instruments from high school custodians and collect them over the course of the tour. And when we get back to New York, we have this big press release party with a lot of media outlets covering it. And we give the instruments to needy high schools all across the United States. Because scientists have found that if you teach your kids musical instruments, they will be less grateful. You can't argue with the statistics, people. So here's a song we like to do. It's called Cloisonné. 1, 2, 3, 4. Chance to play the keyboards? Why, of course, ladies and gentlemen. Sir John Linnell is assembling his So the Cat's Cradle has changed, has evolved so much since the first time we played here. I think
the first time we played here, it was an actual Cat's Cradle. Made of string.
There was just a bunch of cats.
Yeah, the cats were still.
They were kittens. They were actual kittens.
They were, yeah.
tiny, adorable kittens. No, it was like, it held like 8 people.
8 kittens,
yeah.
This song is called Dr. Worm. Came up to me and said, I'd like to buy you my idea. My ideas would appeal to you, though I am not unkind. She looked at me, I looked at something written across her scalp. And these are the words that it faintly said as I tried to call for help. There's only one thing that I know how to do well, and I've often been told that you only can do what you know how to do well, and that's be you. Be what you're like, be like yourself. And so I'm having a wonderful time, but I'd rather be whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark. In the dark, whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark. There's only one thing that I like, and that is whistling in the dark. A man came up to me and said, I'd like to change your mind. By hitting it with a rock, he said, though I am not unkind. We left it as little joke, and then I happily walked away. My head on the wall of the jail where the two of us live today. There's only one thing that I know how to do well, and I've often been told that you only can do what you know how to do well, and that's be you. Be what you're like, be like yourself. And so I'm having a wonderful time, but I'd rather be whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark. You know how to do well, and that's be you. Be what you're like, be like yourself. And so I'm having a wonderful time, I'm whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, whistling in the dark. Whistling in the dark, whistling, whistling, whistling in the dark. I don't know why this hasn't happened more often, since we've been playing forever, touring forever. I was about to sneeze in the song, and I'm thinking, while it was happening, I was thinking, why does this never happen? It's so weird.
We've been doing festivals at nighttime for... Oh, do you think there's a cat here? At the cat's cradle?
Yeah.
We've been doing festivals for years where there's where a lot of times we're playing at night and there's spotlights on us, and I have inhaled bugs.
Yeah, exactly.
And I've been wondering for years why I've been inhaling.
Yeah, we've been inhaling bugs for years.
Yeah, that we're used to.
That's normal.
Inhaling
but sneezing
bugs
is completely unprecedented. In my case, unprecedented. I don't know, have you ever sneezed while singing?
I only inhale bugs.
Right, exactly.
It seems to come at really inopportune moments, like peak moments when I'm about to start yodeling. And it's very hard to explain to 20,000 people when you're about to yodel that you've just swallowed a bug.
That's right. Yeah.
Unless they think you're doing a very focused Marlon Brando impression.
From Apocalypse Now, you may remember, I think he actually swallowed a bug.
Yeah.
Hey, we're telling a long and tedious story up here.
But the important thing you gotta realize is it's going nowhere.
Yes,
exactly.
So you can shout out names of our songs. You can shout out names of other band songs. We're still going to tell the story that has no punchline. So that reminds me of a long car ride I took. I was staring out the windows, and
I got time.
Hey, we want to thank you all for coming out on a Wednesday night. We know it's a school night for us. So here's a song we like to stare at our hands while we play. Ready, John? Ready, Marty? Count it up. Two.
Whoa.
I really thought we were doing a different song.
That reminds me of this crazy road trip I was on.
I really felt like I just swallowed a musical bug. Yeah. I know there's a sheep right there.
He wrote that sheep.
I wrote that. I wrote this set. That doesn't mean I committed it to memory. All right, here's a brand new song off our Nanobots album, ladies and gentlemen. It's called Circular Karate Chop.
Never took a class before in self-defense. Never looked at you before with common sense.
Gathers all he has. God's gladness hangs upon the love of God. The love of God.
Dedicated to all the sexy people in the audience. Thank you.
Pretty little pony.
Sexy, sexy, sexy.
Why, who's that here on stage with us tonight?
Why, it's me, Robot Flans.
Robot Flansburg?
That's right, I'm Pope Robot Flans.
Pope Robot Flans?
Yes.
Why am I speaking this way?
I don't know. It sounds like some Steve Martin record.
It does sound like that.
I bought that record for a dollar, and then I threw it away.
It was so jive and not very funny.
I hate that shit.
I need to go take a shower now to get me off me.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pope Robot Flansburg is here.
Yes, I'm right here. I'm in the back
right here.
I'm not facing the audience because I am...
He has a hideous robot face.
I am omnipotent.
Right, omnipotent.
I'm totally omnipotent. Ladies and gentlemen,
I understand you're infallible as well. That's the other.
I am infallible.
Robotal.
I am infallible. There was a conclave. It appears the people of Carborough enjoyed conclaves. There was a conclave, and after a number of days, white smoke poured out of the room, and the conclave had decided that I would be Pope Robot Flans. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I am infallible. I even have infallible jokes. John?
Yes, Pope Robot.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Panther.
Panther who?
Panther, no pants. I'm going swimming. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, I am infallible. But I did not come here to tell jokes, ladies and gentlemen. We came here to rock you with our brand new album, Nanobots. And even though it does not have a scientific theme, we just like to goof around with this sound on my voice. I sing a B on this song, that's the only note I get to sing. And this is how the song goes. Grow the nanobots.
Thank you.
as your pride flows south to see with the Bristol factory closing up. It's sad to say you romanticize all the things you've known before. It was not so great. It was not so great. As you take a bath, that beaten path, there's a pounding at the door.
Here's a song called Lost My Mom.
Yeah.
Everybody.
People.
joke. When it comes to opera, she's ossified. So all of your operas better step aside. When my friend got amnesia, she can't remember the show she saw. Like the one with the guy with amnesia who got off of the island on a hell of a
thank you. tribute to all the people who hung in on the 1, 2, 3 clapping. That was. We know that we're in kind of like a musical vortex here, and we appreciate the rush-like dedication to sticking to the music no matter what was happening. It was a test. It was a test of your rhythmic will to hang in with that. And you have at least one rock band that appreciates that. I can't speak for other rock bands. They're not here to represent themselves. We do have a brand new album out, ladies and gentlemen. It is available in vinyl form at the t-shirt stand directly behind you. I am making grassy knoll-like gestures towards the t-shirt stand. The t-shirts came from over there. We also want to remind everyone that Moon Hooch is especially grateful for t-shirt purchases. So don't make the mistake that so many other people have made. There's nothing wrong with buying two t-shirts at a t-shirt stand. And of course, it is a customary 18 to 25% tip. That's the New York way. So here's a song that I'm afraid to start. It's about a man named Nikola Tesla. And if you want to impress people, you actually pronounce his name Tesla, not Tesla. And it is a lectern, not a podium. Any other tips for the people out there?
Well, if you want to really impress people, just come up with some completely weird pronunciation that no one's ever heard and insist that that's the real one.
You know? The Tesla.
Yes. It's pronounced Hasma. Please, please, don't mispronounce his name. It's Hasma.
I don't think that would impress my wife, who was the person who impressed on Pongi that it's not Tesla.
No.
I recorded the whole vocal saying Tesla.
Oh, she made you do it over?
Yeah.
Roger Goldie Goldwasser.
This is the power
on the shots.
Of mispronunciation. So here we go. Here's the actual song.
Tesla brought the X-ray photo to the world, brought the AC power to the world.
Grounded in science, we are here to explain something extra scientific about They Might Be Giants for the past couple of years, John Linnell and I, John Flansburg, have become aware that we have psychic abilities far beyond most alternative rock band front people. We have the ability to understand people's true nicknames. Not the nicknames they were given by their friends in high school, not the nicknames that they might have given themselves in college, trying to reinvent themselves. No, ladies and gentlemen, we can see deep into your soul and understand the nickname you might not even realize you have. Wow is right, my friend. Total wow. And I'm not talking sham wow, like Mary Lou Henner on 60 Minutes. We're talking about the real stuff here. Psychic abilities, people. Nicknames. Hundreds of nicknames are flooding our consciousness right now, ladies and gentlemen, as you stand before us. Who knew that there were so many nicknames in this room? John, are you feeling the nicknames in this room?
You know I am. And we're going to tell you what your nicknames are using this high-powered electric light to suck the nickname up to the stage. John, tell me when to stop here. I'm just going to scan. I'm getting this crazy, like, riot of nicknames. Whoa, that guy?
Doppelganger.
It's Doppelganger! People may not know what their nickname is. What do you tell you?
Let me take that over. I know, people don't know.
Okay, I'm getting very, very powerful nickname rip waves. There we go. Yes. That person.
The person who's turning crimson.
The person who's... Your nickname is... Hasmanajniga. I'm not making this... You can't make this shit up, people. I don't know where you get a nickname like that. But that's what we're getting.
John, I'm not. There's so many nicknames crowding out my consciousness right now. I can't. Do you have any other nicknames?
Yes.
Just keep going. Back, front. We have a request for Shitspa, but that's not really a nickname at all.
No. Using our psychic powers.
That's just, we looked into the future and we saw that Shitspa was not a nickname.
It's funny though.
It is funny.
I like Shitspa. I wish we'd thought of that.
John, these people are beginning to resent this light.
Okay, I'm sorry. All right, just stop anywhere. Oh, that guy, we already did him. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. This woman up front?
Sure.
Okay. Deborah Winger.
Deborah Winger, ladies and gentlemen. The real Deborah Winger.
Right. Not the one the man wants you to go see in the movies.
Yeah.
The hoax.
Not the hoax. Not the one who's sleeping in the garden bushes outside your house.
Outside right now. That's not the real Deborah Winger.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we could do this all night long, and that is a threat. But we're going to play songs instead. This next song is off our album, The Els, and it is The Mesopotamians.
Been driving on end of this down to the hour and back. I believe in that.
satellite from London, England. They Might Be Giants is proud to present.
The Avatars of They! Yeah.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening.
What's up?
Hey, Green Avatar. We are very excited to be here. How are you people doing out there? We got a whole set of songs prepared for you people. We would like to thank They Might Be Giants for opening up the show. Warming everyone up. Getting everybody all nice and Avatar headliners. Hey, Green Avatar, I got a question. I friended you on Facebook, but you didn't say it was cool.
I don't have Wi-Fi in the satellite. That's the problem.
No, you gotta accept me as a friend on your Facebook page.
I don't have Wi-Fi in the satellite. Doesn't work.
Does your computer have Yahoo? How's it going out there, everybody? With Sir Axl Rose. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, every syllable is precious.
Live and let die.
We've been working on this song for a while, since the 90s. It's called He's Loco.
With a Green Avatar because he's loco, loco. Don't talk to that guy, don't even look him in the eye because he's loco, 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 loco.
I vote for Eisenhower in every election.
He's loco, 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 loco.
Why I'm investing all my money in the Microsoft
Zoom. Loco, loco, loco.
Break.
Thank you. Look at that.